I come to you in the name of one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. As I describe this, perhaps you'll remember seeing the image that I refer to. And what surprised me is that this image dates to 1888. The image is a black and white drawing of what appears to most people, at least initially, as that of an older woman. However, if you look at the use of space differently, changing the priority of the negative and the positive spaces, the image is that of a young lady. Once you see that second image, it can be difficult to sometimes see the first image. And regardless, once exposed to both images, you cannot look at that image the same way. The same is true for today's gospel. It's a very familiar passage, one that is a call to action. We've each been given gifts according to our ability, and as we are able, Christ calls us to action and to share the grace of our Lord with those in need. The familiarity of this passage is such that, like a good advertising tagline, we use it to promote our acts of kindness. We quote this passage when we ask for volunteers to staff the homeless winter emergency shelter. We likely think about Jesus proclaiming that, "When I was hungry, you fed me," as we gather food for our monthly fish collection. Matthew 25 is a very familiar topic of books, lectures, and retreats. But now that the other image of this passage has been pointed out, like that of an old woman and young woman, I cannot help but notice the different use of negative and positive space that was previously overlooked. Perhaps we can understand that the accursed, those on the left hand, didn't recognize Christ. Their face is not turned towards God, so they did not see him needing food, clothing, and care. If those on his left hand have chosen to not be with God, we can begin to understand how it is that they don't see the image that is right before them. What challenges me is that three times the righteous, those who know Jesus, ask, "When was it that we saw you? Lord, when was it that we saw you hungry and gave you food, or thirsty and gave you something to drink? And when was it that we saw you a stranger and welcomed you, or naked and gave you clothing? And when was it we saw you sick or in prison and visited you?" Those who know and love Christ gave him food, clothing, and care. Yet they didn't see that it was Christ to whom they ministered. Is it that our eyes are open, yet we do not see? Are we fixing our eyes on things earthly and not heavenly? Is it that giving out food or visiting the sick is on our to-do list on our smartphone, and we want to check off that completed task? I get a great noise when I hit complete, and it goes whoop and disappears. Are we so focused on doing that we forget about being? By doing, we will certainly accomplish much. We'll check off many of the completed tasks on our to-do list. By being in the moment, being focused on things heavenly, being one with Christ, then we might see Christ receive the food that we offer. And once we see that image, our view and perspective will forever be changed. In Matthew's gospel, the righteous who are doing marvelous works of providing food, clothing, and care will see Christ, but not until they're in heaven. Those fortunate few who are now focusing on things heavenly and are now being with Christ will see Christ in heaven. They will also see Christ here on earth as they offer the grace of God to the homeless, the hungry, and the downtrodden. They will never be able to view that image in the same way again. Now let's look briefly at Ezekiel. Using the metaphor of a shepherd, the prophet Ezekiel pairs wonderfully with Matthew. "I will feed them with justice," proclaims the prophet. It's not enough to feed the hungry. They should be fed with justice. "I will clothe the naked." It's not enough. They should be clothed with justice. Food, clothing, and shelter addresses basic human needs. Justice goes further and will bring forth changes to correct the systemic issues that result in hungry, naked, and homeless children of God. We have all been blessed with gifts and talents from God, and we are to use them according to our ability. For those who have the ability to feed the hungry, do so. For those who have the ability to feed justice to the hungry and change the systemic issues that brought forth the hunger pains, do so also. With the hope that you will never again view this image in the same way, allow me to illuminate just one example among many that is screaming out for justice. We know that the minimum wage is $7.25 an hour, and there's much discussion about the pros and cons of raising it. To put that wage in perspective, according to a study by MIT, in James City County, the living wage, that amount which you actually need to live and have shelter and clothing, for a family of three, is $25.26 an hour, $52,540 a year. 3.5 times the minimum wage. That equates to a technical healthcare position. It is well above what is earned in retail, food service, and the trades, and serves to highlight how it is that so many homeless people do have jobs, just not jobs that pay a living wage. We can feed the hungry with food. We can feed the hungry with justice, according to our ability. One more image for you this day comes to us from Father Robert Castle, an Episcopal priest who served a largely black and Hispanic parish in New York City. For I was thirsty, sorry. His New York Times obituary said, "He ran an energetic ministry in which spirituality and social action were indissolubly linked." The image he provides reminds us that with God, all things are possible. And it comes in the form of a prayer. Let us pray. O God, who is old and lives on $50 a month in one crummy room and can't get outside. Help us to see you. O God, who is 15 and in the sixth grade, help us to see you. O God, who is 3 and whose belly aches in hunger, help us to see you as you have seen us in Jesus Christ our Lord. O God, who sleeps in a bed with your 4 brothers and sisters, and who cries and no one hears you, help us to touch you. O God, who has no place to sleep tonight, except an abandoned car, an alley, or deserted building, help us to touch you. O God, who is uneducated, unskilled, unwanted, and unemployed, help us to touch you as you have touched us in Jesus Christ our Lord. O God, who is chased by the cops, who sits in jail for 7 months with no charges brought, waiting for the grand jury and no money for bail, help us to know you. O God, who is unorganized and without strength to change your world, your city, your neighborhood, help us to join you. O God, who is fed up with it all and who is determined to do something, who is organizing people for power to change the world, help us to join you as you have joined us in Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.